Morning, childrens.
Very good morning. Today I am going to explain about transgenic plants or genetically modified crops. Okay, so what is this name? Just like it's something like different, right? What is plants? You know, what is a transgenic plants? Yes, it's a plants. Actually, it is engineered or genetically modified as a transgenic plants. For our purposes, we have modified the plants by using the genetic engineering tools. Okay, so this genetic engineering or the genetically modified crops are two videos are there. Today I am going to explain about part one. Okay, so this definition or introduction to the transgenic plants is the transgenic plants contains a novel DNA. That is, if you are seeing the plant having their indigenous DNA, that is, it have its own type of DNA. In that DNA, we are going to incorporate some different DNA, that is some foreign DNA, outside DNA, exogenous DNA is inserted. So that DNA is called novel DNA, which is introduced its genome, that is, which is introduced its complete genes. Okay, so this is about the introduction to the transgenic plants. Weeds are constant problem. What is called weeds? Unwanted plants in the field of the agricultural field is called weeds. Okay, in this weeds is our constant problems in the crop fields. Why? Because if we are not removing the weeds in the field, the weed may taking the nutrients and the sunlight and for and for the water and all those things, it is compete with the crops. Crops is a plant which is growing in the agricultural field is called crop. So these weeds are constant problem. It cannot change the, we cannot remove this completely. The weed will be coming again and again. By removing this weed, we can stop the competence of the nutrients and sunlight water regarding to that. Okay, and also this weeds is carries the insects and diseases, they are telling. Okay, if you are not controlling the weeds definitely causes the crop yield reduced. Okay, so if you are getting a 10 bags of the paddy, if the weed is disturbing the crop, definitely you will be getting the 5 bags. So definitely it affects our yield. Okay, so first of the transgenic plant is two type is the herbicide tolerant is there, and another one is the insect tolerant is there, virus resistant is there. So first I am going to explain about herbicide tolerant, that is glyphosate. So glyphosate is nothing but in this glyphosate, it is introduction of a BOR gene through the vector. Okay, BOR is a type of gene which is inserted into the vector. Okay, so in this type, if you are seeing this introduction of the BOR gene through the vector, so this gene have the tendency to give the resistance to the glyphosate herbicide. Herb means plants, side means killing. That is, herbicide means if any weeds is there, okay, if weeds means that is unwanted plant which the weed does not want. Okay, so if you are taking the weed kala edukkaradhu solvanga tamil, right? So adu madri and the weeds, we have to remove that weeds. Okay, so that they will be spraying the glyphosate herbicide on the weed. Okay, so that the weed will be destroyed. So that when we are spraying that herbicide, the crop should not get damaged with this herbicide, so that only we are using this protocol to introduce the BOR gene into the crops. Okay, so if you are paddy, we are doing the agriculture means in the field, in that field we have to insert the BOR gene into the crops, so that the BOR gene, that is cell culture potato with the BOR gene, and herbicide tolerant potato cells, that is potato plant, will be grow nicely, and callus meaning is undifferentiated mass of the plant. Okay, plant initial stage we cannot differentiate that, so that it is called callus. So after that, true root, stem, leaves, all will be or arises from that, so it is called organogenesis. Okay, then development of the, if you are seeing this diagram, this is just a protocol for the tolerant of the glyphosate. by the potato plant. The one strategy is incorporate the soil bacterium gene that produces a glyphosate tolerant form EPSPS, that is enol pyruvate cicate phosphate synthase, is an enzyme. That enzyme is produced by the soil bacterium. Okay. So this enzyme will give the tolerancy to the glyphosate. Another way is to incorporate a different soil bacterium gene that produces a glyphosate degrading enzyme. Okay, so this is one method, is we can give the gene introduces into the bacteria, thereby the EPSP, that is our enol 5 enol pyruvate plus kimate 3 phosphate synthase enzyme will give the tolerant capacity to the plant. And the another way, the soil bacterium gene that produces a glyphosate degrading enzyme. So one is to block enzyme, another one is glyphosate degrading enzyme. There are two strategies for the herbicide tolerant in the potato by the glyphosate. And advantages of this tolerant capacity, we can control the weed and high crops we can get, and reduces of the herbicide we can, and by spraying a little bit amount to the weeds, the weed will be removed, because already the yield will have the crops having the tendency to tolerate them. And also the competence between the weed and crop is much reduced. Okay, use of low toxicity compounds which does not remain active in the soil, low toxicity compounds which do not remain sorted. So it does have the low toxicity, so no problem with the soil. It does not change the soil texture or the soil water or the soil wear or the pH. Okay, the ability to conserve the soil structure and microbes. So in the soil consisting, soil is a separate world. It consisting of water and pH and all those things. It does not disturb at any moment. Okay, like this we have to, this next time coming to the herbicide tolerant Basta. Basta is nothing but, that is our Basta. It's a type of plant. Its trade name is Basta, refers to non-selectable herbicide. Okay, the chemical compound which is present in the Basta is called L-phosphinotrasin from the Medicon sativa plant. It inhibits the enzyme glutamine synthase, so that the ammonia assimilation will be disturbed by inhibiting the glutamine synthase. The PPT gene was introduced into the tobacco, and transgenic tobacco produced was resistant to the PPT, that is phosphinotrasin. Similar enzyme isolated from the Streptomyces hygroscopix with the bar gene encodes the PAT enzyme, that is phosphonitrosrin acetyl transferase, was introduced in the crops like potato and sugar beet. Transgenic plants have been reduced or have been developed. So this is about your Basta, same thing of your this thing, but here they'll be using a Medicago sativa plant to take up the phosphinotrasin. This compound is inhibit the enzyme of the glutamine synthesis, thereby the amino assimilation, ammonia assimilation will be stopped. Okay. Next I'm coming to the insect resistance, that is BT crops. That is BT crops means, that is our reduced, that is insect, this plant, some of the plants is going to be a resistance to an insect. If the insect is coming, like if you are taking the potato, if you are taking the tomato or the brinjal or the cotton plant, the insects is coming and eating the plant and stem, it causes the bore in the, it causes the well grew or the opening or the hole in the stems and leaves and roots. Different kinds of diseases will be caused by the insects, that the plant should resist the to stop the insects. Okay, so that we will be using the BT cotton, the genetically modified pest resistant. Pest in the sense it is an insect. The insect resistant plant cotton variety which produces the insecticide activity to bullworm. If you are taking a cotton plant, definitely the cotton plant is most probably 90% is affected with the bullworm. Okay, that bullworm is a type of insect. It is most frequently attack our cotton plant. So that's that we have to create some insecticide, that is insect is an insect and side is killing of the insecticide activity. We have to make ready our plant. By this technique, that is strains of the bacterium, Bacillus thuringiensis produces 200 different types of BT toxins. That is, Bacillus thuringiensis is a bacterium. That is, we short form, we are telling it's a BT toxin. The BT toxin is giving the different types of toxin. That toxin producing genes we are going to incorporate into the bacteria, incorporate into the cotton plant, so that it is called BT cotton. Okay, so that toxin is just produced by the bacterium. It can able to kill the 200 harmful effects causing different insects. BT toxin insecticidal to the larvae of the moths and butterflies, beetles. What kind of insects will be died by this BT toxin insecticidal to the larvae of moths and butterflies and beetles and cotton bollworms and gadflies. These are all different kinds of diseases, and is not caused any harmless to the other's life. That is, our own plant, our desired plant, cotton plant, will not affected by this insecticide. Only the insect get affected by this plant. Okay, this is just diagrammatic representation of the BT cotton. Next, mechanism. Mechanism is nothing but genes are encoded for the toxic crystals. Okay, so how the plant, okay, suppose the BT toxin producing bacteria, that is Bacillus thuringiensis, having special genes. That genes is encoded toxic crystals, that is called cry group of endotoxin. Okay, what is that cry group of endotoxin means? It's a gene coded by the toxic crystals. When the insect is attacking and eating the cotton plant, the cry toxins, which is cry toxin producing genes, which is already present in the plant we just incorporated, this cry toxin producing genes, which is entered into the dissolved into the insect's stomach. So the epithelial membrane of the gut, it is get blocked, and certain nutrients, thereby sufficient regulation of the potassium ions and loss insects. Okay, so result in the death of epithelial cell in the intestine membrane, which leads to death of larvae. Larvae is nothing but initial stage of the insects. The insects is completely developed is called insect, but before it is developing as an insect, that is a very early stage or very young stage of the insect is called larvae. In that stage is killed by our cry group of the toxins or the endotoxins, which is given by the genes which is encoded in the BT toxin, which is incorporated in the BT cotton through the genetic technique. When the bollworm or other type of flies is coming and eating that cotton plant, it is definitely all the cells, plant cells of the cotton, is entered into the stomach of the insect. The stomach of the insect in epithelial membrane is blocked by these toxic crystals. It stops the potassium ions entered and outside of the cells of the epithelial membrane of the insect, so that it is ultimately the larvae get died. First its intestinal membrane get blocked, and then automatically the death of the larvae takes place. This is just mechanism of the BT toxin. And advantages and disadvantages. Advantages of the BT cotton are, it is commonly increased due to the effective control of the bollworms. Bollworms is main sources, main disturbance and main affecting the BT cotton. That will be reduced mainly. And the insecticide used in the cultivation of the BT is will be, by using this technique, the insecticides is got mainly reduced. And potential reduction in the cost of cultivation also. The cost is very much reduced by introducing this BT cotton method. Next, disadvantages. The cost of the BT cotton is high. So the cost of the BT cotton seed is high, in the sense it is expensively it is high, and the effectiveness up to the 120 days after the efficiency is reduced. Ineffective against the sucking pest, like, so its effect only 120 days. After that we have to again we have to refresh it. Okay, then ineffective against sucking pests like jessets, aphids and whitefly. Aphids, whitefly, these kind of the insects which cannot killed by this cry group, by this BT cotton, affects the pollinating insects and thus yields. Okay, pollinating insects, if the insects is get killed by this method, so the pollination ranges will be mainly got reduced. Next, BT brinjal is nothing but same thing. But here also the crystal protein gene, that is Cry1AC, is a protein gene. It's a name of the gene from the soil bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis only. It is this gene is main importance is having the promoters, terminators, antibiotic resistant markers. Okay, it gives the antibiotic resistance to the brinjal plant, which is using the agrobacterium mediated genetic transformation. Agrobacterium tumefaciens, I explained you in the last video itself. Okay, by using that bacterium, they are just transferring the gene from the Bacillus thuringiensis to a brinjal plant with the help of agrobacterium mediated. Because this bacterium will have the tendency to transfer any particular gene into the any particular desired plant. Okay, so this BT brinjal has been developed to give resistance against the Lepidopteran insects, that is that particular, it's a kind of particular insects, that's example Leuconoids orbonalis. Okay, Leuconoids orbonalis is an insect, these kind of, these variety of the insects which get resist by this BT brinjal, because it causes the boring, short borers into the fruit of the brinjal, that is brinjal vegetable. If you are taking the many of the vegetable, that is our brinjal vegetable, here and there if you are cutting inside or the outside, we can see some borings, that is done by the Leuconoids orbonalis, is kind of the insects amazing that. So that will be reduced by using this crystal protein gene, which is taken from the Bacillus thuringiensis, which is transferred from the Bacillus thuringiensis to brinjal with the help of agrobacterium mediated genetic transformation. Next, Dara mustard hybrid is nothing but the mustard is, it's a kind of hybrid variety, it's a herbicide tolerant, which is initiated by the Delhi University. It's a government sponsored project, it's a government project, it's not a private project, and it is created by using Barnasi or the Basta technology. In this, the soil bacterium is makes a mustard self-pollinating. So DMH, that is Dara mustard hybrid 11, contains three genes, that's Bor genes, Barsanin and Barstar genes, which is taken from the soil bacterium, and this Bor genes is making resistant to the herbicide named Basta. Okay, why it is called Basta? Because this Bor gene, which is taken from the soil bacterium, and also it is consisting of three types of genes, so that it is called Basta. Next, virus resistant. Virus is an important problem that causing even the loss of the yield in the, even in the death of the plant, that will be avoided by giving the resistance to the plant against the virus, is called a virus resistant. Virus resistant genes is inserted into the plant so that the virus is the, so that the plant is escaped from the virus. Okay, so this is main important. And the tomato, that is flavor sour tomato, means it's a tomato only, the tomato has become resistant to the virus, is called flavor sour tomato. So in this we are using this genetic engineering technique by using of agrobacterium making as a flavor sour tomato. Okay, to get, why we are doing this? To get the natural color and flavor of the tomato, and through the genetic engineering we can make this, by you doing this genetic engineering technique, we can just ripening the process of the tomato and slow down that. Okay, so it is not get ripened soon. Okay, the process of the ripen will be get slowed down by this agrobacterium genetic engineering technique. Okay, and also it is preventing it from the softening and to increase the shelf life. If the general tomato, it has have the tendency to live freshly in the 1 week, means it is taking the time more than 10 days. Okay, the tomato was made more resistant to rotting. So rotting means it get degraded. So that degradation also delayed by this technique. So the, all the process will be done by the enzyme, that is polygalactouronase, which helps the delaying the ripening process and long storage and the transportation. So long storage, we can keep it for the long storage, and the softening and the ripening delayed. Softening is delayed. Long storage and transportation is mainly done by the enzyme enzyme that is polygalacto-uronase, that's done by the achieved by the agrobacterium mediated genetic engineering. Next, I'm coming to the golden rice biofortification. This is very, very important. Why it is called biofortified? It is enriched rice. It's not only the namesake golden rice, it's also called enriched rice. Okay, the golden rice also called Oryza sativa. This is here we are using the genetic engineering technique to synthesize the beta carotene is a precursor of the vitamin A. Vitamin A is very, very important for our eye problem, for our eye goodness, eye healthiness. We need a vitamin A. That vitamin A is taken from or originated from or synthesized from beta carotene. To consumed in areas with the shortage of the dietary vitamin A, which kills so many children under 5 years age, right? So if you're taking African countries, in some parts of the African countries, the children's get died by below the 5 years of age due to the deficiency of the vitamin A. For their point of view, for that particular area point of view, they are created or they are made or manipulated these kind of the golden rice is called the biofortification. So what they are doing, it's additional, the general rice have the different kind of combination. Addition of 3 beta carotene synthesis in the, that is pitoin synthase from the daffodil plant and Negritius pseudomonasius, and crit 1 gene is taken from the soil bacterium, that is Erwinia arododora, and like Lycopene cyclase gene is taken from the wild type rice endosperm. Our general rice consisting of the like gene, okay, that like gene is a Lycopene cyclase, is an enzyme is responsible produced by like gene in the normal our rice endosperm. And different two plants they have used soil bacterium like Erwinia arododora is giving the crit 1 gene is giving, and also it is giving the Necritius pseudo aratus, that is Cypitonis synthenis. These 3 genes is plays a major role to become a normal rice, become a golden rice for the vitamin A production, that is enriched golden rice. And in the endosperm of normal rice does not contains any beta carotene, but golden rice has the genetically altered to become the endosperm should accumulate with the beta carotene. This golden rice definitely control the child blindness like xerophthalmia in the parts wherever the children's is very shortage of the dietary peoples, okay, or the malnutrition student, malnutrition children's. Next, this is just diagram of the golden rice, and the benefits is there and risk is there. The benefits is highly risk without pest is thing, and 70% of the reduction of the pesticide is usage. The reduced soil pollution problem, and also it's conserve the soil population, soil microbes population in the soil. And it is a risk is it's affect the liver, kidney function, and also it have the chances to causes the cancer. And hormonal imbalances and physical disorders, anaphylactic shock and allergies. Some may allergic with this anaphylactic shocks of the some of the some proteins of this plant, this altered, that is this golden rice altered plant is, that's adverse effects in the immune system because of the bacterial protein, loss of viability in the seeds show the dominator seed technologies of the genetically modified crops. And polyhydroxybutyrate is nothing but it is just the synthetic polymers. Generally our polythene papers, or you know that it is non-degradable and it is polluting our environment and soil. And when it is burned, the dioxin is released in the environment, which may have the tendency to cause us the cancer. And for this, we are doing eco-friendly biopolymers. That is, we are preparing a polythene cover by using a biological organism, especially plants. That is called polyhydroxyalkanates and polyhydroxybutyrate. Okay, these are all the degradable, easily degradable biopolymers. Okay, which is used in the several medical applications like drug delivery and scaffold and heart valves are used. Medical application, even the heart valves also made it by these kind of the plastic like a degradable things. Okay, this polyhydroxy alkylates thermoplastics and it is easily biocompatible and biodegradable. Okay, several microorganisms are used, like a gram positive organisms is used to take up this polyhydroxy butyrate, like a Bacillus megaterium, Bacillus subtilis and Cornibacterium glutamicum, and gram negative bacteria like a Pseudomonas species and Alkaligenes eutropus. Okay, so polyacetic acid is a polyelastic acid, biodegradable and bioactive thermoplastic. It is aliphatic polyester derived from the renewable sources like a plant varieties, like polyacetic, that is polyhydroxy butyrate is taken from the microorganisms like gram positive and gram negative bacterium, but polyelastic acid is taken from the, it is also biodegradable and bioactive thermoplastic bags only, but polymers only, but it is taken from the plants like corn starch, cassava roots, chips or the starch sugar cane. This kind of this thing is made at, and yes, these PLA's two main monomers are the lactic acid and cyclic diester is there. The most common route is a ring opening polymerization lactate with a metal crystal like this octate in the solution. This is just mechanism of the metal catalytic reaction result in the equal amount of polylactic acid. This is just a diagram of the polylactic acid. Thank you all.